Welcome to this session. In this session, we are going to focus on how memory management works in Java. The core topics we are going to focus on is stack, heap, comparison between stack and heap, and how the garbage collection mechanism works in Java. So here, besides the stack, heap, and the comparison between both, we are going to focus on the complete garbage collection mechanism and how it works in Java, along with the different ways in which objects are unreferenced. Let's start with the stack. Now, a stack is basically a data storage mechanism which stores data in memory in a certain flow, and you basically can go and store a collection of multiple objects. It simply follows the last in, first out algorithm. So the last value that you put into the stack is the first value that will be retrieved. So there are three basic operations that you can perform in a stack. You can add an element into the stack at the top, which is called a push. You can remove an element from the top, which is called a pop. And in case the stack is empty, you will simply get an underflow error. And then there is a top operation, which simply puts out or pulls out the method which is at the top of the stack. We have an isEmpty method that returns true or false depending on whether the stack is empty or full. If you look at the diagrammatic example, the first shows you is empty true, indicating nothing in the stack. Then we push a value A, then we push a value B. If I retrieve the top item, first A, then B comes out. Then I push a value C, then I say top, C is retrieved. And if you say pop, in that case, I will be able to pull out the first item from the top, which is C, and then the top item becomes B. Now, if you look at memory allocation, Java basically consists of this stack collection or data structure, which is part of the random access memory where temporary data is stored. And the usage of this, where you want to perform a small task or a process which has a certain value to be stored with it, but it's not for a long-term storage. So that is the use case where this can be used. All the variables that are stored on the stack exist for as long as that particular block of code that stored the value is executing. Always the total capacity of the stack will vary, and it depends on how many methods are creating what sort of variables that require storage. There is a size limit depending on the OS and the available RAM on your system, and that's the reason the moment the memory is allocated, it is also freed up for new variables to be stored. Now, let's try and understand the reason behind the stack being used only for storing local variables. So, what are the limitations of the stack? Well, with the stack, you can only remove the last item you have added, and that works very well for the local variables since they come and go, you know, as the execution of the program moves on. They will be like a floating audience that you see in a marriage hall. And it does not work very well for data where the life cycle does not really depend on the individual function. So this entire memory structure where the data is stored as a heap basically allows you to keep adding and removing any kind of data as you want when the program is going. So let's now understand further how Java uses this heap for memory. So because the stack has these kind of limitations where you can only remove the last item, it works well for local variables, does not work well for data that has to be stored for a long time. And that's the reason we have a heap that is available. Okay, now let's look at a heap. So the heap is again the area in the RAM which is used to store objects. Here the memory management is not automatic, nor is it very stringently managed like the stack. So you would need to manually go and free all of the allocated memory where the blocks are no longer required, and there is no size restriction for a heap, and that's how it compares to the stack. And however, the objects in the heap are a little slower to access because of the algorithm that it internally uses. So the heap is divided into two parts. You have the young and the old space, okay? And this is managed by the Java virtual machine. So the garbage collection is an algorithm running in Java in the background, which keeps freeing up the memory at regular intervals. And it only frees the object in the old space using first in first out mechanism, not the young space. So the old space is where very previous variables that you have stored in the old place, you may want to clean them up now, they have been stagnant for a long time. And so the first value to be inputted is the first value to be outputted. So first in, first out is the methodology. So coming to the differentiation, so the stack is static memory allocation and heap is used for dynamic allocation on the fly. The variables on the stack, they are accessible directly from memory and thus it runs faster. And heap is a little slower. Heap, on the other hand, the memory allocation is all done when the application is running. And in the stack, when you compile the program, that's when the allocation is done. So the stack and the heap are different ways that Java uses to store data. Let's talk about now how this memory is managed automatically using this garbage collection thread or process that runs in the background. So any kind of object that you're not referencing in your code, why do you want to let it hog memory in the background? So this is a process that cleans up those unreferenced objects and it is again performed automatically and thus it provides a much better memory management capability for your program. So in case the heap is full, the garbage collection will start with the older objects that are not referenced any longer and clean them up. So that's the benefit of the garbage collector, which looks at the heap and keeps doing the cleanup. Now what is an unreferenced object? If you set the object to null after initializing it and storing it, you know, allocating memory for it. For example, if we say student S is new student, then I say S is null. That means the student object is not being referenced any longer. Or S1 and S2 are new student objects and S1 is now pointing to the same memory location as S2 when we said S1 equal to S2. So the first object will now be available for garbage collection. Or if I say new student, it's a temporary anonymous object without a name just for the purpose of accessing some method, etc. in the class. In that case, it is immediately destroyed because it's an unreferenced object. We can also go and request the garbage collector using some of the methods like finalize and GC to do a cleanup at regular intervals. And this GC method is found in the system and runtime classes. For example, here we have a small block of code where we are calling the finalize method. In the main method, which is the entry point, we are creating two objects of some sample class called testGarbage1 and we are setting them to null, which means it's unreferenced, and then system.gc is the garbage collector call where we request it to go and do a cleanup of these unreferenced objects. So the output of this program will be object is garbage collected. So the finalize method will be called automatically just before the unreferenced object is being removed from the heap. We'll now move to the demos for module 2. Again, we'll right click. We can create a new class file, give it a name. Let's say I want to test garbage collection and I give the name as test garbage and say finish. A new file will get created. If you look at this file, we've created a finalize method which acts as a destructor, which means it will execute just before the object is no longer required and is deinitialized. We've initialized two objects of the test garbage class in the main method and we have set both of them to null. The moment we set both of them to null, we are requesting the system to call the garbage collector with a system.gc, which indicates that it will garbage collect S1 and S2 and the finalize method for each of those objects will execute. So if I execute this, the keyboard shortcut to execute the program is F11 or the function level key. Hitting function level executes the program and it says object is garbage collected, indicating finalize is called once for each object. So as a summary to this module, we have understood a couple of things. We have focused on the memory management, differentiation of stack and heaps in Java, and the ways in which objects are unreferenced, along with understanding finalize and GC methods. So we looked at the stack, the heap, the differences, what is garbage collection, and finalize and GC method. Thank you.
I hope you have enjoyed listening to this video. Please be kind enough to like it and you can comment any of your doubts and queries and we will reply them at the earliest. Do look out for more videos in our playlist and subscribe to EduRekha channel to learn more. Happy learning!